3 My FM. It is Val inside of the morning. Do First Sip here, Kevin?
Yeah, if you've never heard First Sip before, you have been missing out. This is the way to start the day, especially a Friday. First Sip, it feels good. Valentine delivers a few positive words to get the day started right, and then we all raise our cups high and toast the day together.
Hans Christian Andersen said something years ago that reminded me of a thought that I've had on and off throughout life, and I thought it'd be appropriate for today's First Sip. For many of us, we're always thinking, hey, waiting for that knight in shining armor, waiting for that fairy tale, whatever. You know, we have this picture of reality sometimes, which is distorted by our youth or the media or anything else around us that tells us this is what we're looking for, this is what we need. And we're always waiting for that fairy tale, but sometimes we miss out. Life itself is the most wonderful fairy tale. That's what Hans Christian Andersen said years ago. And I think we have to remember that too, the life we're living can be an absolute fairy tale. We don't have to go searching for one. It's around us at all times. Just open your eyes. It's right there in front of you. Brian looked me in the eye creepily at that moment.
Count us up, Joe.
1, 2, 3.
Oh, my gosh. I was like, whoa.
life itself is the most wonderful fairy tale. There's your happy ending. It's 104.3 FM. This is Valentine in the Morning.
Here's what's coming up in Hollywood headlines. Right after traffic, I'll tell you about Kelly Clarkson's not one, but two Emmy nominations.
Three things you need to know right now.
Ventura County has become the first county in Southern California to receive approval from the Department of Public Health to move forward on an accelerated path to reopening. That means that restaurants can begin offering dine-in options and some stores are permitted to have customers come inside. In order to qualify for an accelerated reopening, counties must prove that the number of people testing positive or being hospitalized is either stable or declining. A recent survey has found that nearly 70% of Americans do not remember the last time they wore real pants. The majority of people working from home say they're spending their days in pajamas, leisure wear, will put on an appropriate shirt for video conferences. Over half of people surveyed also admit to working from bed. Gosh, we have to remember, in some respects, these aren't good times.
Well, it's kind of depressing.
I don't know. Working from bed, not wearing pants. On Monday, a formation of 18 historic airplanes will fly over the Inland Empire, Los Angeles, and Orange County, saluting both veterans on Memorial Day and local healthcare workers. The event's being called Operation SoCal Strong. It's going to take off from Loma Linda Medical Center at noon on Monday. The organizers of the flyover say it's meant to be a salute to all veterans who gave the ultimate sacrifice for the freedoms we enjoy and to honor the frontline healthcare worker heroes of today. That can be very cool. So I don't know what the planes are, but 18 historic airplanes, I'm going to bet you're going to see things like a B-52, or you're going to see old bombers, or you might see, you know, P-51 Mustangs and things like that. So, you know, it could be really, really, really cool stuff. Who knows? There you go. Those are three things you need to know.
Welcome southbound side of the 405 freeway. If you're coming into Van Nuys, just before you get to Sherman Way, some debris fell on the back of somebody's truck and hit another car. So the right lane is blocked off now by that car that's left behind, and your drive is slowing down just away from Roscoe. Kind of sluggish to the 101, but it's much improved for your drive through. This will help it pass. Northbound side of the 110 freeway slows down through South LA. You're on the brakes at Florence over towards the 10, and then it's better to downtown. Northbound side of the 5, just past the 10 freeway. Something's in the lanes there. If you see what it is, let me know on the traffic tip line, 888-500-5003. It's quickly backing up the drive, coming away from the 6010 westbound and slowing down. It's trying to transition there to the 5 freeway as well. And on the 5 freeway, northbound side, just past the 710, there's a pickup truck that broke down, blocking the left lane, so you'll see delays as you come up on Atlantic. This traffic report is sponsored by Albertsons and Bonds.
Sweet, juicy cherries, packed with nutrients. They're one of the healthiest foods you can eat. Right now, get large California cherries for just $1.88 a pound at Albertsons and Bonds. Limit 6 pounds, price valid through May 26th, with club card where applicable.
From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, we make it easy.
Valentine in the Morning.
Hollywood headlines. Louis Capaldi, Noah Cyrus, and Phineas are just a few of the artists performing tonight for St. Jude's Prom from Home under the living room lights. It's going to be a virtual event that will also be a fundraiser to support the hospital, and the live stream will start at 4 p.m. our time on YouTube and Twitter. And the nominees were just announced for this year's Daytime Emmys. They're going to take place on Friday, June 26th, with winners and other special guests appearing from their homes. The nominees for Outstanding Game Show Host include Wayne Brady for Let's Make a Deal, Steve Harvey for Family Feud, Alfonso Ribeiro for Catch-21, Pat Sajak for Wheel of Fortune, and Alex Trebek for Jeopardy. And then our friend Kelly Clarkson, nominated for two Daytime Emmys, one for Outstanding Entertainment Talk Show for The Kelly Clarkson Show, and then also for Outstanding Entertainment Talk Show Host. So congratulations to Kelly. I'm Joe with the Hollywood Headlines.
All right, we do have the Battle of the Sexes coming up at the 7 o'clock hour. Then right after that, we're going to launch into Happy News on our Friday. We always do Happy News on Friday, and it's a fun time no matter what's going on in your life. Try and find something positive and share it on the air, and that positivity becomes absolutely, astoundingly, wonderfully. I'm trying to find another word for infectious.
Yeah, that's not a good word these days.
When I chuckled, I couldn't find it, so let's just move on.
Okay.
Shareable becomes astoundingly, wonderfully shareable. It becomes viral. No, not good either. I gotta get a thesaurus in front of me or something, you know? All right, it's 104.3 MyFam. It's Valentine's Day morning.
There's a fire.